Hey guys, so we start with question 5. So a storage tank in the shape of a cuboid has a capacity of 108 meters cubed. It has a square base of side x meters with vertical sides and is open at the top. Express h, and h is the height, in terms of x. Okay, so express h in terms of x. Right, well, first of all, we look at the volume of a box, and the volume of the box equals length multiplied by width multiplied by h. Okay, so let's see what we can put in here. We know the volume is 108. We know the length is x. We know the width is x, so length, width, and the height is h. So 108 equals x squared h, so if we divide by h on both sides, we get 108 over, sorry, if we divide by x squared on both sides, because we want h on its own, so we get x squared equals h. Okay, so now we have height in terms of x. Okay, so that was the first thing we had to do. Second thing, show that the surface area S is given by x squared plus 432 over x. Okay, so let's look at the surface area then, will be the bottom bit here. Right, so it'll be x multiplied by x, okay, that's the bottom bit, plus it'll be this side here, which will be x multiplied by h, and it'll be this over here, so x multiplied by h, and the back bit, x multiplied by h again, and a bit over here, plus x multiplied by h. Notice I have 4 x multiplied by h's. So I can say x multiplied by x, which is x squared plus 4 x multiplied by h. Okay, but we know that h in terms of x is 108 over x squared. So instead of putting in the h, I replace that with 108 over x squared. And then simplifying this, we will get x squared plus, multiply the 108 by 4, and we get 432. And the x squared on the bottom is dividing. So if we multiply all that by x, then we just have an x in the bottom rather than an x squared. So the surface area is that. And if we look over here, that's what we're asked to prove. Last one then. Find the dimensions of the tank. If the surface area is there, but if the surface area is to be a minimum. Okay, so find the dimensions of the tank if the surface area has to be a minimum. Right, so we're talking about surface area, and we're talking about minimum. Right, so here we go. S equals squared plus 432 over x. So we need to differentiate that, we need to let it equal 0, and we need to solve. So if I differentiate this, I get ds dx equals 2x. And well, actually, I'm going to write this a bit different just to make it a bit easier on myself. So s equals x squared, and I hate to differentiate these fractions, so I'll call this 432 to the power of minus x to the power of minus 1. Okay, so that there and that. So how I got from there to there is your rules of indices. Okay, think about it. 1 over x is the same as x to the power of minus 1. So 10 over x would be the same as 10 multiplied by x to the power of minus 1. And therefore, 432 over x is the same as 432 multiplied by x to the power of minus 1. So if I differentiate that, so ds equals 2x minus, because we multiply the 432 by minus 1, so we get minus 432 x to the power of minus 2, because we have to decrease our power by 2. So that's it differentiated. Now we let it equal 0. But before I do, I'm going to tidy it up, because I don't like this minus 2 here. Okay, I want to change it back into something like this fraction again. So that will be 2x minus 432 to the power of x squared. Okay, and we'll let that equal 0. Okay, so I want to get rid of this x squared, so I'm going to multiply across by x squared. So 2x by x squared is 2x to the power of 3, and 432 over x squared multiplied by x squared is 432, and 0 multiplied by x squared is still 0. And I can divide by 2 the whole way across, and I get that, and that is 216 equals 0, x cubed equals 216, therefore x is the cube root of 216, which is 6. Okay, so what we're after finding is to find the minimum value, or the minimum surface area of this tank, then the x value has to be 6. Okay, so x must be 6. So if we look back at the tank, then I'll just fill in what the dimensions are, or what they have to be. So x was 6, that was 6. H, well, if we look over here, we said h equals 108 over x squared. So we find out what h is, so 108 over x squared, which is 36, and that would give us 3, so the height of the box then must be 3. We were asked for the dimensions, we weren't asked for the actual surface area, so we don't have to give it to them. Okay, so that's that done. Okay, this question then, we have a square sheet of card of size 12 centimetres, and has 4 equal squares of side x centimetres cut from the corners as shown. The sides are then turned up to make an open rectangular box. So if we look here at this image, okay, we have this square in the middle, and we have these bits here, okay, coming out. If we turn them up, we'll make a box that we can put stuff in, right? And the length from here to here is 12, and the length from here to here is x centimeters. So they say express the volume of the box in terms of x. Okay, well, the volume of the box, if I was to draw it out a little bit different, let's say like this, the sides would be turned up. Okay, so that's what it would look like when the sides are turned up. Right, the height would be x, because I'd be able to turn up that side. This bit here, though, it wouldn't be 12, because I'd have to take off the two x's. So it would be 12 minus 2x. So the volume of the box then would be length multiplied by width multiplied by height. Well, the length, so this bit here, say, is 12 minus 2x. The width, 12 minus 2x, and the height then is x. And if I multiplied all that out together, I would get 4x cubed minus 48x squared plus 144x. Okay, so that's the first bit done. Just when we're multiplying out them brackets, take two at a time, so take maybe these two, can get your answer and then multiply your answer by x, and you will get to this. Okay, next thing. Show that the volume of the box is a maximum when x is 2. Okay, well, let's find its maximum. Okay, let's find its maximum. And after finding its maximum, we should realize then that its maximum is when x is 2. So what do? I take this, I'll differentiate it. So it is so volume equals 4x cubed minus 48x squared plus 144x. So dv dx then equals 12x squared minus 96x plus 144. Okay, we're going to let that equal 0 and we're going to solve it. So 12x squared minus 96x plus 144 equals 0. Could do the guide number, could do the minus b formula, but you know me, I like factorizing. I can divide across by 12, and it'll leave me with x squared minus 8x plus 12 equals 0. That makes it a lot easier on me. If I was to factorize it out, then give me x minus 2 and x minus 6. So x minus 2, x equals 2, and x equals 6. Okay, now one of these is a maximum, one of these is a minimum. Don't just think straight off that 6 is the maximum. Okay, we won't know until we put it in there, and then we'll put the other one in. Well, actually, not that one, sorry. No, sorry, I might. We will take the 6, we'll put it in there. We'll take the minus 2, we'll put it in there. Whichever gives us the biggest answer is the maximum, whichever gives us the smallest answer is the minimum. Okay, I'm not going to do that for you. I would presume, though, based on how the question is worded, that when we put in the x equals minus 2 into there, we get the bigger answer. Okay, okay, next question. Okay, here's the next question. The given diagram, and there is the diagram, shows a cylinder cut from a solid sphere of radius 3 centimetres. Given that the cylinder has a height of 2h, find its radius in terms of h. Okay, so I want to find the sphere cylinder's radius, which is from here to here. I know that the radius of the sphere is 3, that's from here to here. I want to know what the height is from here to here. Oops. From here to here. Okay. Now I know that the total height of the cylinder is 2h. So therefore, from the middle of the cylinder, which is here, to the top of the cylinder, must be h. So I'm going to just draw that right angle triangle out here. I know that's 3, I know that's h. I want to find out what that is. Okay, so I'm not going to do it for you, because straight away you should cop that that's Pythagoras' theorem. So r equals square root of 9 minus h squared, using Pythagoras' theorem. Okay, there's my h, hypotenuse, there's my opposite, and there's my adjacent. Work it out, you get this. Okay, you get the radius, in terms of h. So that's that done. Right, second, hence show that the volume of the cylinder is given by this. Okay, well, volume of a cylinder. So write out the formula. Volume of the cylinder is pi r squared Doesn't look too hard. So that equals pi multiplied by the radius squared, which is the square root of 9 minus h squared, or to be squared, multiplied by h. Now, don't get confused, that h stands for the total height of the cylinder, and the total height of the cylinder is 2h. This h now is only coming from the formula, okay? So don't get confused. So the height of it is 2h. So that'll give us pi multiplied by, now, root 9 minus h squared ought to be squared. Well, it's just 9 minus h squared multiplied by 2h. Okay, so simplifying that then, we have 2 pi h multiplied by 9 minus h squared. Okay, I'm sorry. This question, I wrote it down wrong. This question squared was in here. Okay, so there, it's getting a bit worried there. Right, there we go. Right, next thing they say is now find the maximum volume of the cylinder. Well, we have a formula for the volume of the cylinder. I'll multiply it out though, okay? I don't want to be using the product rule, okay? There's two things being multiplied by each other here. Look, I don't really want to use the product rule, so I'll just multiply it out, which I can do. Okay? Instead of using the product rule, you can multiply it out. So if I multiply this out, I will get 18 pi h. Okay, that's just multiplying the 2 pi h by 9. And then multiply it by 2 pi h cubed. Alright. So, that's the volume. When differentiated, let it equal 0 and solve for h. So dV dH equals 18 pi, okay, just if you're confused with that, have a look over here, 18 pi h. And this is just a number, okay, because pi is 3.14, so 18 multiplied by 3.14 is just a number, okay, and we'll multiply that by h, and this h, it's just like the x's, okay. So if there's a number, let's just call it, well, 18 by 3.14 is probably about 74h, and if I was to differentiate that, I just get 74. Okay, so likewise, if I'm to differentiate this, I'll just get 18 pi minus, and likewise, 2 pi is just a number, so we take the 3 and multiply the 2 pi by 3 and we get 6 pi. And then we reduce the h by 1, and we get h to the power of 2, okay? Okay, so I could divide across by 6, and I get, I get 3 pi minus pi h squared equals 0, so we had to let it equal 0. I could divide across by pi as well, and I get 3 minus h squared equals 0. H squared equals minus 3, so h squared equals 3, so h equals root 3. So there's h when it's at its maximum, and we will take that then and we'll put it in for h here, and we'll put it in for h here, and we'll get the maximum volume of the cylinder. Okay, so that's that one done. Last question. A beam has a rectangular cross section of depth x and width y. Okay, so I've done that. Look, there's the beam. Okay, it's cross section, so it's like if I cut it down the middle. The strength of the beam is given by this, 5x squared multiplied by y, and the perimeter of the cross section is 120. So that must mean this plus this side plus this side plus this side is 120. And the first thing we're asked is to find y in terms of x. So we should be kind of used to it now. the perimeter equals x plus x plus y plus y. Now the perimeter is 120, which is what I know. I have 2x plus 2y. So if I take the 2x over here, it'll be 120 minus 2x equals 2y. Divide across by 2, and we get 60 minus x equals y. So there you go. There is y in terms of x. And it says express s in terms of x. And s is up here. We have it expressed in terms of x and y. So instead of putting in the y, we will put in 60 minus x. So it'll be purple s equals 5x squared multiplied by 60 minus x. Okay, so that's that one done, that one done. This is what are the possible values for x. We'll have a look here. Okay, I'll rewrite this. S equals 5x squared plus 60 minus x. And that gives us the strength. Okay. Now strength has to be a positive number. Would you agree? Okay, I can't have a minus strength. So whatever value I put in here for x, it has to give me a positive value. Now if I put in 10 here for x, that'll be fine. If I put in 50 here for x, that'd be fine, because they would all give me positive values. The only time I won't get a positive value is if I put in 60 here for x. If I put in 60 here for x, watch. 60 minus 60, which is 0. And it can't have a strength of 0. Yeah, there's no real such thing as strength of 0. Even an air would have more of a strength than 0. And if I put in 70 here, well, that will be minus 10, and can't have a minus strength. Right? So, with that logic, I can say x will be between 0 and 60. So it'll be greater than 0, but less than 60. Okay? So that's that done. Okay, the next one says find the values of x and y. X and y that give the strongest beam. Okay, just delete this and give myself a bit of room. The strongest beam. Well, the strongest beam is another way of saying the maximum strength. And here's a formula for strength, and I want to find the maximum strength. So I'll take this formula, I'll differentiate it, I'll let it equal 0, and I'll solve for x. Now, again, this here, it's a bit messy, you know. If I was to differentiate that as it is, I'd have to use product rule. I don't really want to, so I'll just multiply it out. Okay, so I'll multiply this by this and this by this. So s equals 300x squared minus 5x cubed, and that's a little bit easier to differentiate. So then ds dx equals 600x minus 15x squared. Let it equal 0. And divide across by 15 then. And I will get 40x minus x squared equals 0. I can try factorize this then. Get the x. This should work. X by x, x squared. No, not quite. Minus x. So x by minus x squared. X by 40, 40x, that's fine. So x bit. So x equals 0, that's dealing with that bit, and then this bit. We have minus x plus 40 equals 0. Okay, I'm just letting both parts equal 0. I'm letting this bit equal 0. I'm letting this bit equal 0. And I will get minus x equals minus 40. So x equals 40. Okay. Now remember we said already x couldn't be 0. Ok takes if I put 0 in there. It just wouldn't work, okay? I mean, it would have to be more than 0. And also, think about it this way. If x was 0, okay, well then this wouldn't be a shape at all, really. Okay, it wouldn't have a depth, so it can't be 0. So without doing anything really, I can just say that x would be 40. Now it did ask for the x and y values, I think. Yeah, find the values of x and y which give the strongest beam. Well, x will be 40. Now y, let's have a look up for the formula for y. Y is 60 minus x, so that's 60 minus 40. Y, so y is 20. Alright, so the strongest beam, this here would be, 40, and this here would be 20, okay, based on the fact that it has a perimeter here of 1. Right, last bit then. If the cross-sectional depth of the beam must be less than 19 centimeters, find the maximum strength of the beam. Okay, so it has to be less than 19 centimeters. So this x here has to be less than 19 centimeters. So x must be less than 19 centimeters. Let's just take this. 5x squared, 60 minus x, so 5x squared, 60 minus x. I'm going to find the strength when x is less than 19. Okay, so we put in 19, right? Because x could be equal to 18.9999999 all the way up, just barely to 19, right? So we put in 19. And when you work all that out, you get 74005. Okay? And really what it's gonna be is 7400 and 4.9999999999, as close to 5 as possible, but not quite. Okay, so but that's as hard as you get, guys. All right, so that's it. Hope that made sense. Okay, bye.